Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel Civil Engineering Education. Today in this video we are going to learn about steel reinforcement, which is a versatile construction material in all RC structures. So what is reinforcement, types of reinforcements, what are the grades of reinforcements and diameters of steel bar, and how to find out the weight of steel bars. So let us learn the topic in this video. Don't skip the video in middle, watch the video till end. So as we all know, rebar, it is a versatile construction material which is used in all the RC structures. So first point, if you observe, so it is a versatile construction material which is used in all the RC structures. Now coming to second point, it is manufactured from ferrous material. So it is manufactured by using the iron. Ferrous material is nothing but iron, and it is denoted by Fe. Now coming to the purpose of rebar, why we provide rebars in RC structures, that is the question mark. So the reason for providing the reinforcement is to prevent the tensile failures. So mainly to prevent the tensile failures, we are going to provide this steel reinforcement, and also in compression members to decrease the size of a cross section, and also the to increase load carrying capacity of a particular member. For example, if you take this beam or a slab, this is the tension member. Whenever we apply the load on this member, what will happen? The beam will tends to bend like this. So when the beam is bending, automatically the cracks will be occurring here. So when the cracks are occurring, what will happen? The concrete will be failing, and the beam will obviously it will fail. So this is the reason, to prevent this kind of failures in tensile zone, we'll provide steel reinforcement. So mainly slabs, beams, etc. So these are the tension members in which we provide in tension zone. So coming to the concrete, so concrete, it is good in compression and it is weak in tension. This is also one of the important reason why we provide steel bar mainly in tension zone. So if you take this beam, so this is neutral axis. So top zone is called compression zone and bottom zone is called tension zone. So concrete is good in compression zone and it is weak in tension zone. So that is the reason we provide steel bar based on the concrete material. Now coming to steel bar, steel is good in compression as well as tension. So steel can take both the forces, like compression force and also tensile force. Now coming to the fourth point, the heat of thermal expansion of steel is similar to that of concrete. So in our mind, the question will raise that why we are using only steel, we can use any other material, because here the thermal expansion of steel and concrete is almost the same. So this is the reason why we are using only steel. Now coming to fifth point, it is easily available material. So steel rebar is very easily available material, so we can supply any quantity of steel to any construction project. So next one is, it develops good bond with concrete, as the steel bars are having ribs. So these are called ribs, so which it can develop proper bonding with concrete. So it is also good in bonding. So seventh point, it increases load carrying capacity in compression members. So in almost all the compression members, we can decrease the size of compression members by providing the steel reinforcement. This is also one of the important reason why we use steel bar in all the RC structures. So let us see next topic. Now we'll see what are the types of reinforcement, grades of steel bars, and also brand names, and also diameters of steel bars. So first one is types of reinforcements and IS codes. So this is mild steel bar, and the code book used is IS 432 part 1. Next one is HYSD bars, the code book used is IS 1786. Third one is steel wire fabric, and the code book used is IS 1566. And for structural steel, we use IS 800. So these are the types of reinforcements in general we use for all the RC structures as well as the steel structures. So these are the code books which we follow based on the type of steel reinforcement. Now coming to grades of steel bars. So these are the general grades of steel bars which we use. Fe 250, this is nothing but this is a mild steel, and these are HYSD bars. So here Fe 250, Fe 415, Fe 500 and Fe 550 are there. So Fe is nothing but this is ferrous material, that is nothing but iron. So this is the abbreviation for ferrous material. Now what is 415? Here 415 is nothing but this is the yield strength that is measured in Newton per mm square. So this is nothing but Fe and 415. Now coming to brand names, there are some brand names which we use in our RC structures. So for example, if you take Vizag TMT, so what is TMT here? TMT is nothing but thermomechanically treated bars. So the abbreviation for TMT is thermomechanically treated bars. Second one is HYSD bars. So the abbreviation for HYSD is high yield strength deformed bars. Now third one is Tata Tiscon and fourth one is JSW. So these are the some brand names which we use in our construction projects. Now coming to the standard diameters of bars. So these are the standard diameters of bar which we use in our constructions. That is dia 6 mm, 8, 10, 12, 16, 20, 25, 32, 40. These are the diameters of bars which we use in our construction project. So additional to this one, so diameter 36 and also diameter 45, 50 can also be availed by ordering to the manufacturing companies. Now we'll see what is the standard length of steel bar, what is the unit weight of steel bar, weight of steel bar per meter length, and weight of bars per meter length for different diameters, and also BBS table. If you see the standard length of steel bar, it is 12 meters. We should remember that the standard length of steel bar, it is 12 meters length, or it is nothing but 39.36 feet, approximately it is 40 feet. For each bar, the total length will be 12 meters or 40 feet approximately. Now coming to unit weight of steel. What is the unit weight of steel? It is 7850 kg per meter cube. That is nothing but density of steel. Now coming to the weight of steel bar per meter length. So to calculate the weight of steel bar per meter length, if this is 1 meter length of bar, dia 8 mm or whatever it may be. So for this one, we need to find the weight. So how we will calculate the weight? So this is the formula which is used to find the weight of bar per meter length. So to find out the weight of bar per meter length, we will use d square by 162.2. So this derivation already I have prepared one video. I will give the link in description. You can watch that video how we got this d square by 162.2 and also d square by 533. Now the second one is weight of steel bar per feet. Here in this formula we can calculate weight per meter length, and here we can calculate per feet length. So d square by 533, this is the formula which is used to find the weight of steel bar. Now for example, if you take 8 mm steel bar of meter 1 meter length, now the formula is d square by 162.2. here d will be in mm, d we should take only in mm. So here 8 mm dia I am taking, so 8 into 8 divided by 162.2, this is the formula. So I will get kg per meter. So this is the answer in kg per meter, that is for 8 mm 0.394 kg per meter. So similarly we can see different diameters of bars. So weight of steel bars per meter length for different diameters. If you take 6 mm, the weight is 0.221 kg per meter. If you take 8 mm, 0.394. If you take 12 mm, 0.887 kg per meter, and also similarly for 20 mm it is 2.4466 kg per meter. So similarly 25 mm, 32 mm, 40 mm. So this is the procedure how we will calculate the weight of steel bar per meter length as well as per feet. Now coming to next one, this is BBS table. To find out the quantity of steel required for a particular project, we will use this table to calculate the total quantity. So if you observe, it is also called as a BBS in abbreviation. It is nothing but bar bending schedule. So here in this bar bending schedule, so these are the headings which we are going to use for calculation. First one is serial number, type of bar, and this one is diameter of bar, number of bars, length of one bar, and total length of bar, weight of bar per meter length, and total weight and remarks. So these are the columns which we use for calculation of quantity of steel. So further in further videos I am going to explain you how to write this table. So this is the topic for today, and if you like the video, hit the like button, and if you are new to the channel, subscribe the channel and follow. Thanks for watching.